This is Alan Bush with the Daily Financial Forecast for Tuesday, April 9th. Stock index futures under some pressure today, as it appears now that the Trump administration is threatening tariffs on the European Union. So tariffs back in focus. However, I'm inclined to think that we will see some recovery here. These trade issues with the EU have been going on for quite some time now. Also, earnings in the first quarter are likely to be weaker than what we had last year. Of course, earnings are paramount to individual issues, but when looking at the broad indices, there's probably nothing more lagging than earnings for the overall stock index futures, possibly money supply, which is also a very much a lagging indicator. So these are basically indicators that are several months old, at least 3 months old. So I would not be overly concerned, at least with the indices, looking at the earnings forecast, especially now that it appears that many of the world's major central banks are moving toward accommodation. And that should be the dominant fundamental that we look at, which is why I remain long-term bullish stock index futures. And the currencies, interest rate differential expectations, basically are offsetting. I don't think there's much to do in any of the currencies right now, especially in the pound, which, of course, the UK is so political now. Any political market should normally be avoided. There's really not much more political as far as any of these markets than what's going on in the UK. Interest rate markets, also we're seeing offsetting influences with the slowing global economy being a bullish factor, progress in the US-China trade talks being a bearish factor. However, I very much like the long side of the industrial commodities. I would focus my attention there, especially in the copper and the crude oil. So a lot of the fundamentals remain aligned to the bullish side of those markets. Any breaks should be used as buying opportunities. Also, my next upside objective in the crude oil is at 70.50. So good trading, everyone. Once again, remember, these are my opinions alone and are not the opinions of ADMIS or Archer Daniels Midland.